There was something distinctly different about today's Murdoch papers. Climate change suddenly on the agenda in a big way.
How the world's racing to save the planet.
Vic power plant worker backs change from coal.
How much solar panels will save you?
Getting Australia to a net zero future.
Now, major newspapers covering our single greatest existential threat shouldn't be noteworthy, but this is News Corp we're talking about.
We should approach climate change with great scepticism.
Another day, another big global warming scare. Frankly, another big global warming con.
Basically, the renewables scam are riding on the coattails of fear-mongering about climate change.
Even the so-called experts have been forced to admit climate change isn't the cause of these bushfires.
We are talking about a global warming hoax.
With control of more than half the Australian newspaper market and the influence of Sky News, News Corp's helped turn the issue of climate change into political kryptonite.
The Murdochs have been out there campaigning against climate change action for more than a decade. We've seen this one election campaign after another.
12 million hectares of our country burnt last summer, and your newspapers were saying it was all the consequence of some arsonists. And James Murdoch was so disgusted, he dissociated himself from the family business.
So what's changed? Well, with nearly 80% of all Aussies backing net zero by 2050, they've probably been dragged towards the light by their audience. But while it may be a decade too late, Murdoch's Road to Damascus moment is still great news for fans of a habitable planet, potentially clearing the decks for the PM's long-awaited net zero commitment due this week.
The world is moving into a new energy economy. It's now a question of how, not if.
So while it's not ideal to let a foreign kingmaker help write your climate policy, at least that kingmaker's finally on the side of science.
Well, there you go. I mean, obviously, I wrote a weekly column for the News Limited papers, so I should say that up front. But look, both sides of the climate debate have always been prosecuted in the Murdoch papers. I mean, you might not like to believe that, but it's a fact. And if you went back through the years, you'd see that. But the loudest voices have been the sceptics, and so that's the ones you hear. People like a good friend of mine, Andrew Bolt, people like Rita Panahi, people like Peter Credlin. But what they've done here, according to Joe Hildebrand, who's put this together, who used to be on Studio 10, the editors have sat down and said, let's have another look at climate change, and in the lead-up to Glasgow, let's prosecute the argument again.
But let's not pretend they just sort of had a meeting of minds. I mean, there has to be a commercial reason. Well, there has to be something that makes this the moment where they suddenly all... Like, really, they just suddenly all agree like that? I'm welcoming it, by the way. I'm not having a go at it. But there's got to be more to it than what
I can't argue that. I mean, there might be all sorts of theories. I don't know. All I know is what I was told today by talking to Joe, that the editors sat down at one of their annual conferences and said, we need to get back into a debate about climate change, and so they're now going to have it. We should all welcome that.
Do you think
Australians should welcome...
mind about Glasgow?
Well, I think Australians should welcome the fact that they're now open again to another argument about it. What, there's nothing wrong with that. It's a good thing.
What's interesting is...
Yeah, just a bit sceptical.
Well, I think if you join the dots with Scott Morrison and Glasgow and the News Limited papers, yes, there might be maybe an argument that that's all connected, but I don't know. What are you smiling for?
She's happy. We're all on the same team now.
I just love what a funster he is.
Fun day.
Tried to make a joke of it.
I don't think Monday rhymes with fun day at all.
With so much content online, it's sometimes hard to keep up with it all. And let's face it, who has the time? The project YouTube has you covered with the stories that matter. Hit subscribe for a daily list of the news that you need to know.